Hey, you guys. I'm gonna share with you this quickie recipe reveal. And this is perfect for the little kids in the kitchen. And this is a recipe my mom made for us when we were little kids. I haven't had this in forever. But all you need is one or two cans. You might want two cans or more if you want more of a gravy sauce. And pork chops, and I was really looking hard for the thin pork chops with the bone, because back in the 60s, that's how my mom made this meal. There was like six little thin as paper pork chops with the bone in, and I was looking for them, and they don't sell them like that anymore. Sell the super thick one with the bone, so that's what I ended up with. So anyways, get your pen and paper, and when you have your little one in the kitchen, they can season the pork with salt and pepper and sometimes I put a little bit of onion powder, but I really don't, because my mom back in the day, all she seasoned with was salt and pepper. So season your pork chops with salt and pepper and refrigerate for a couple hours. Then get your your mushroom soup, and you know, mix it a little bit with water. Not as much as they say, because when you put it in there with the pork chops, it's gonna have some grease. And then pour it over your pork chops and decide how much grease. That's all it is. But for little kids, and I always put foil on the bottom of the pan, it's an easier cleanup. And I always cover it with foil. It just seems like it keeps the meat juicier. I don't know. But all that stuff is fun for kids. The salt, the pepper, the getting the pan ready, and watching the timer. And so there you have it. And here's my dish. I already spooned out some sauce in my dish. Gravy. I guess I call it gravy. And then pop it in there. And the best thing to eat this with are mashed potatoes. I believe I forgot the salt shaker. And you can buy those bags of those quickie instant mashed potatoes with a ton of butter. And your kids, all the kids do to make those instant baked potatoes is add water. So much fun for kids. And then this is your gravy. This is something from my childhood past that I loved, and I thought I'd just rekindle the recipe in case we forgot, and we can do it with our kids. Of course. There is one spooky thing about pork. I don't know if you want to even talk about it, but I heard that the bad thing about pork is that pork has a parasite that can never be digested. Have you guys heard that? Look at that. I don't know how true that is, but It still doesn't keep me from eating pork chops and bacon occasionally. And there's the Brady Bunch show when Bobby Brady takes on the character of Humphrey Bogart. He wants to, I forgot what the show was, but he wanted to have an exciting personality. I guess he thought he had a boring personality. So, somewhere in the show he has his mom. And he says it's an Humphrey Bogart impersonation. So what's for supper? Carol Brady says pork chops and apples, and Peter Brady says pork chops and apples. And he did a really cute little Humphrey Bogart impression. So of course I always think of that when we have pork chops. And I forgot what the lady's name was. She had a puppet named Lamb Chop. So cute. Can't remember that lady's name. But anyways, kind of a fun little recipe with a little mug. Just thought I'd share it with you. It's kind of a spooky Sunday. Can you hear the Santa Ana winds outside? Super, super hot. And these winds are blowing around. Dry. Eating always helps to relieve the stress, right? And the salt and pepper seasoning is perfect because you get flavor when you have the soup as the sauce. And then especially if you have I've got my digestive enzymes. Sometimes I try to buy cheaper